problems on Cauchy's nth root test. Test the convergence of the series n to the power n squared by n plus 1 to the power n squared. Let us consider the given series as series un. Therefore, let un be equal to n to the power n squared by n plus 1 to the power n squared, which is greater than 0. That is, everything is positive, because where n is a natural number, here everything is in terms of n, and hence it is positive. That is, the given series is a series of positive terms. That is, un equals to n to the power n squared by n plus 1 to the power n squared greater than 0 for all n belong to n. What is the nth root of un? Nth root of un is equals to n to the power n squared by n plus 1 to the power n squared whole to the power 1 by n. Now, here the terms within the bracket having n squared as a power in numerator as well as in the denominator. Therefore, this can be written as n by n plus 1 to the power n squared whole to the power 1 by n. Now, the power is 1 by n. Here we have n squared, that is n into n. Therefore, 1 n get cancelled. That is equals to n divided by n plus 1 to the power n. Now, in the denominator, we take n out. Therefore, the next term will be n divided by, we are taking n out from the factor n plus 1. Therefore, n into 1 plus 1 by n to the power n, to the power n. That is equals to, here n and n get cancelled. Therefore, that is equals to 1 divided by 1 plus 1 by n to the power n. That is equals to, this is 1 to the power n. 1 to the power n is 1 divided by 1 plus 1 by n to the power n. This is the nth root of un. Now we have to take limit. In the root test, we know that limit of un to the power 1 by n as n tends to infinity is L. Therefore, we start with L. L is equal to limit of nth root of un as n tends to infinity. That is equals to limit of the nth root of 1 by n, the nth root of un, the nth root of un is 1 by 1 plus 1 by n to the power n. Therefore, the limit of nth root of un as n tends to infinity is equals to limit of 1 divided by 1 plus 1 by n to the power n as n tends to infinity. That is equals to 1 divided by limit of 1 plus 1 by n to the power n as n tends to infinity. Here, we need not to apply limit in the numerator, because in the numerator there is no n at all. Therefore, apply limit only to the denominator. And we know that limit of 1 plus 1 by n to the power n as n tends to infinity is e. Therefore, that is equals to 1 by e. What is the value of 1 by e? Which is less than 1. Why less than 1? We know that the value of e lie between 2 and 3. That is, 2 is less than e, less than 3. Take the reciprocal, then 1 by 2 greater than 1 by e greater than 1 by 3. That is, the value of 1 by e lie between 1 by 3 and 1 by 2. And naturally, 1 by 3 is less than 1. What is 1? L value. So L value is less than 1. L value is less than 1. Hence by root test, the limit is less than 1. Therefore, the given series is convergent. Test the convergence of the series x to the power n divided by n to the power p. Let us consider the given series as series un. That is, series un is series x to the power n by n to the power p. Therefore, un is equals to x power n by n to the power p. Now, what is the nth root of un? Nth root of un is equals to nth root of x to the power n divided by n to the power p. Here in the numerator, x to the power n to the power 1 by n, n cancel, though we have only x, divided by x to the power p divided by n. Now apply limit on both sides. Limit of nth root of un as n tends to infinity is equals to limit of x divided by n to the power p by n as n tends to infinity, that is equals to, in the numerator there is no n at all. Therefore, we need not to apply limit in the numerator, but we have to apply limit in the denominator. Therefore, limit of n to the power 1 by n as n tends to infinity to the power p. And what is this value? Its value is 1. Therefore, it is x by 1 to the power p. What is 1 to the power p? Is 1. Therefore, it is equals to x by 1, that is equal to x. And x is non-zero. X is non-zero. Thus, the limit of the nth root of un is x. What is x? The root test says that if the limit is less than 1, it is convergent. If the limit is greater than 1, it is divergent. Equals to 1, it fails. But what is x? What's the nature of x? We don't know. We know only that x is non-zero. X is a non-zero real number. It means x may be greater than 1, x may be less than 1, or x is equals to 1. Therefore, by Cauchy's root test, the given series un converges if x is less than 1. X is less than 1. Because x is not equal to 0. Diverges if x is greater than 1. And the test fails if x is equals to 1. Here we have taken x is from 0 to 1. The reason is the given series is the series of positive terms. Series of positive terms. Therefore, the given series converges if x is lie between 0 and 1, diverges if x is greater than 1, and the test fails if x is equal to 1. Can you leave as it is? The test fails. Can you leave as it is? No, we should not leave. Suppose we write exam. We fail in one subject. Shall we leave as it is? If we leave as it is, we don't get degree. We have to apply for supplementary. Similarly, since the test fails when x is equal to 1, we have to find some other method to find the nature of the series when x is equals to 1. Therefore, if x is equal to 1, what happened to un? What is un? Un is x to the power n by n to the power p. Now, x is equal to 1. Then what happened? It becomes 1 to the power n divided by n power p. What is 1 to the power n? It is 1. Therefore, un becomes 1 divided by n power p. Un equals to 1 divided by n to the power p. Apply limit on both sides. Limit of un equal to limit of 1 by n to the power p as n tends to infinity. And we know that this series un is equal to series 1 by n power p is exactly the p series or the p test. And we know that the series un converges if p is greater than 1, diverges if p is less than or equal to 1. Therefore, when x is equals to 1, the root test fails. But using p test, now we have found the nature of the given series. So if x is equal to 1, the series converges if p is greater than 1 and diverges if p is less than or equal to 1. Thus we have two cases. By root test, the given series converges if 0 less than x less than 1. By p test, the given series converges if p is greater than 1 when x is equal to 1. By root test, the given series diverges if x is greater than 1. If x is equal to 1, what happened? The series diverges if p is less than or equal to 1. Therefore, we have to combine these two. And hence, the series converges if 0 less than x less than 1 and p is greater than 1. And the series diverges if x is greater than 1 and p is less than or equal to 1. So if we combine these two, the series un converges if 0 less than x less than 1 and p is greater than 1 and diverges if x is greater than 1 and p is less than or equals to 1. Therefore, the nature of the behavior of given series depends upon two values, namely x and p. If x is between 0 and 1 and p is greater than 1, it converges. If x is greater than 1 and p is less than or equal to 1, it diverges. Problem on Cauchy's nth root test. Test the convergence of the series 2 squared divided by 1 squared minus 2 divided by 1 to the power minus 1 plus 3 to the power 3 divided by 2 to the power 3 minus 3 divided by 2 to the power minus 2 plus 4 to the power 4 divided by 3 to the power 4 minus 4 by 3 to the power minus 3 plus so on. Let us consider the given series B, series UN. That is, series UN is equals to, here remember that I used two colors. One is blue and there is red color. That is 2 squared by 1 squared minus 2 by 1 to the power minus 1 plus 3 cubed by 2 cubed minus 3 by 2 to the power minus 2 plus 4 power 4 divided by 3 power 4 minus 4 by 3 to the power minus 3 plus so on. What is the nth term of the series? If we consider the first term, what's the power? Minus 1. In the denominator, 1, 1. In the numerator, 2 squared, 2. Here also 1 power 2. This is first term. In the second term, what's the power? Minus 2. N is 2. Here 2. Denominator, 2, 2. Second term. Whereas here, 3 power 3. 3. By 3. In the third term, what's the power? Minus 3. Denominator 3, 3. Numerator 4 power 4, 4. 3 power 4. So what would be the nth term? The nth term will be minus n. The power is minus n. First term, minus 1. Second term, minus 2. Third term, minus 3. So, nth term will be minus n. Here, 1 means 1, 1. 2, 2, 2. 3, 3, 3. Therefore, it is n. It is n, n. N, n. It is 2. If it is 1, here it is 2. So, 1 plus 1 is 2. Here is 2, it is 3. So 2 plus 1, 3. It is 3, here it is 4. So 3 plus 1, 4. Therefore, it becomes n plus 1 to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 minus n plus 1. So this is the nth term of the given series. So the nth term of the given series is n plus 1 to the power n plus 1 divided by n to the power n plus 1 minus n plus 1 divided by n to the power whole to the power minus n. Now our aim is to find the limit of nth root of un. So first let us find nth root of un. Nth root of un is n plus 1 to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1 minus n plus 1 by n to the power minus n to the power 1 by n. So this n and this n get cancelled. Hence we get minus 1 here. Therefore nth root of un is n plus 1 power n plus 1 by n power n plus 1 minus n plus 1 by n to the power If you consider the first term of nth root of un, the power is n plus 1 for numerator and denominator. Therefore, taking power n plus 1 as a common. Therefore, it becomes n plus 1 by n to the power n plus 1 minus n plus 1 by n to the power minus 1. Now, what is the value of n plus 1 by n? Dividing by n. N by n is 1 plus 1 by n. Therefore, it is 1 plus 1 by n to the power n plus 1. Similarly, minus n by n is 1 plus 1 by n. Therefore, 1 plus 1 by n to the power minus 1. Minus 1. We know a to the power minus 1 is 1 by a. Therefore, it is equals to 1 divided by 1 divided by 1 plus 1 by n to the power n plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 by n. That is equals to 1 divided by, here 1 plus 1 by n is a common factor. Therefore, take 1 plus 1 by n out. When you take 1 plus 1 by n out from here, we get 1 plus 1 by n into 1 plus 1 by n to the power n. To the power n. Here n plus 1. When you take one factor out, becomes n minus 1. We are going to apply limit on both sides. So limit of nth root of un as n tends to infinity is equals to. We have to apply limit both to the numerator and the denominator. But in the numerator there is no n at all. Therefore, we need not apply limit to the numerator. Therefore, we write 1 divided by, apply limit in the denominator. There are two factors. 1 plus 1 by n is one factor. Another factor is 1 plus 1 by n power n minus 1. Therefore, we have to apply limit to both the factors. So, limit of 1 plus 1 by n as n tends to infinity into limit of 1 plus 1 by n to the power n minus 1. As n tends to infinity, we know that 1 by n tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. Therefore, that is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus 0 into. So, it is 1 divided by 1 plus 0. But we know that limit of 1 plus 1 by n to the power n as n tends to infinity is e. E. Therefore, this is E minus 1. And hence, it is 1 divided by 1 into E minus 1 is 1 divided by E minus 1. What is the value of 1 by e minus 1, which is greater 1 or equal to 1 or less than 1? Which is less than 1? Why it is less than 1? Since e lie between 2 and 3. So 2 is less than e less than 3. That is, e is greater than 2. Therefore, e minus 1 is greater than 1. Subtracting 1 on both sides. So e minus 1 is greater than 1. Right? It's reciprocal. 1 by e minus 1 is less than 1. Thus, the limit of nth root of un is L, that is less than 1. Less than 1. By Cauchy's root test, the series is convergent.